I'm Battalion Chief Mike Gala, and I'd like to welcome you all to the Fire Department headquarters today for the official launch of the FDNY New York Blood Center Critical Days Program press conference. This exciting initiative brings monetary donations to FDNY-related charities for blood donated in the FDNY's name. You'll be hearing more about the program in a few minutes. I'd like to begin by recognizing a few people joining us today. From the FDNY, Fire Commissioner Nicholas Scapetta. Chief of Department, Salvatore Cassano. And Chief of Operations, Robert Sweeney. From the New York Blood Center, New York Blood Center President and CEO, Dr. Christopher Hillier. And the New York Blood Center Vice President, Pasquale George. From the New York Police and Fire Widows and Children's Benefit Fund, Vice President Larry Ehrlich. And representing the New York City Bravest Scholarship Fund, Kate Lynch. And now Commissioner Scapetta will say a few words. Commissioner?
Hold me to a few words. Well, good morning, everyone, and thank you all for coming today to help us get out the word about a really critically important issue, and that is blood donations and keeping up the blood supply in New York. It's a tough time of the year for people who need blood transfusions. Supplies get low towards the end of the year. Donors are a little bit harder to find through this season. People are away and are occupied with other matters. And that's why the FDNY and the New York Blood Center are asking all FDNY employees, family members, and the public to donate blood this holiday season. And when you donate, to use the group number 4FDNY, number 4FDNY. If you make a donation anytime between December 18th and January 11th, and you use that group number, it's very important to do that, the New York Blood Center will contribute $10 to one of three terrific charities that benefit first responders and their families. The New York Police and Fire Widows and Children's Benefit Fund, New York City Bravest Scholarship Fund, and the Carlos R. Lillo Memorial Scholarship Fund would be the beneficiaries if you use that code and give blood. Now, our firefighters and our emergency medical personnel, obviously, every day of the week, do a great deal for the city of New York. Also, with respect to this issue, we are traditionally one of the most generous donors to the Blood Center. That benefits the public, of course, and sometimes our members need help too. And this is a chance for everyone to do that, to give back not just to the city as a whole, but also to every first responder who put their lives on the line every day of the week. And I cite just one case because, is Matt here? Matt Long? Matt's one of my heroes. He should be everybody's hero. Matt Long was badly injured 4 years ago when he was hit by a bus while riding his bike on his way to work as a New York City firefighter.
Well, I'm living proof that it's important to give blood whenever you get a chance to. People need it, and there's people that rely on it on a daily and weekly basis, but my accident, I was one of the largest recipients of a single accident, a blood recipient, and Without it, I wouldn't be alive. It's a very simple and easy step. A millisecond of a pinch and pain, and then it's over. And it's probably the most unselfish gift you can give.
His astonishing recovery really began with those blood transfusions. I suspect without them, Matt wouldn't be here today. So I thank Dr. Hillier, the New York Blood Center, and all of our partners here for their valued friendship and very, very important partnership over the years. And I thank Matt once again, can't thank him enough for all he's done, for coming here today to put a face on the importance of this very, very critical issue of adding to the blood supply. And of course, I thank in advance all New Yorkers for stepping up to help in this holiday season.
At New York Blood Center, we need about 1,500 units of blood every day to keep the city and all of our recipients alive and well. All of us are partners in this, from being donors to potentially being, as the commissioner said, recipients. We are very honored today to kick off this critical day's partnership and relationship and to continue our amazing partnership with FDNY. So we thank Matt for putting a face on it. We thank all of you for coming, and we thank the fire department for its incredible work for our community, and in addition, being one of our biggest and bravest donor groups. So thank you very much.
We're priding ourselves on our volunteer support. So we have volunteer blood donors. We have volunteers helping to set up the blood drives. And forever we give incentives to people to donate blood, and they're generally tokens. You know, like we give a T-shirt or a mug or things of that nature. And we started a couple of years ago having a program that we also call the Advantage Program, where people actually get points, just like you get, you know, on credit cards, you get points for making blood donations, and then you can choose from like an online store. And so we are trying another avenue, which is to, reward people with more charity. So we to do double good in a way. And the idea with this particular program is to direct donations towards periods of times where we are having a hard time finding the blood. So this is a pilot project, and we hope by having this contribution of $10 to a fund selected by the fire department, we hope that it will allow us to make better utilization of our resources, eventually not just for this one, but to move blood drives into the months where we have not enough activity and our staff is idle, and free up the months where we have too much activity and our staff is working double, and then we potentially have service problems. So it's part of like evening out the blood supply.